Senator Rubio, too bad you're not here
Good
at
morning.
The airport
Good
diner, or I'd buy you breakfast today.
I'm hungry, though.
I bet you are. What happened?
Well, look, what happened is obviously Saturday night the debate went the way it went, and then just the media coverage over the last 72 hours was very negative about it and so forth. And so the last thing voters heard going into the booth yesterday was, you know, something bad happened on Saturday night. And so it made it very difficult for us to get any other message across. If you look at the margins between third place and fifth place, I mean, you're just talking about a couple thousand votes out of almost 300,000. And so that made a difference. And I felt bad. Our supporters worked really hard. They did a great job. Our team here did a great job. To the extent that we finished shorter than we wanted to, I think it had to do with the fact that Saturday night and the last 3 days and the coverage. So that's on me, and that ain't never going to happen again. And we're looking forward to South Carolina. We're headed there right now, and we're getting back on the road here. We're going to win this campaign. We're going to win this primary. It's important for the country, and I'm fired up about that.
Well, Senator Rubio, when you say it's not going to happen again, what do you mean by that? Because what, as we famously know now, Chris Christie, he was hammering you, clobbering you about the fact that some of your answers sounded like rehearsed sound bites that you just repeated over and over. Does that mean you're going to completely blow up your narrative?
Yeah.
No, first of all, it's silly because all these guys repeat over and over again. I mean, every single one of them, I can give you five lines they say every single day. But beyond that, let me just say that the difference is this. I went into that debate in the hopes that Republicans didn't have to attack one another. I didn't want to spend 60 seconds beating up on another Republican because I think it helps the Democrats. Hillary Clinton would pay for us to do that all night long. But ultimately, we're not at a stage where we need to be clear with people about our record, what I've done in the past. This line that somehow I have no experience is absurd. It's true, I haven't lived as long as some of the people running for president, but I have more foreign policy experience than any of them, a lot more. And that's the most important job of a president. The most important job of a president is to be the commander-in-chief and to keep this country safe. And more importantly, looking forward, we're going to talk about the future of this country, which is what all elections are about, but never more so than right now. Because one of the things I'm criticized for is saying the truth, and I'll continue to say this. Barack Obama is undermining this country. He is hurting this country. He is doing serious damage to this country in a way that I believe is part of a plan to weaken America on the global stage. This is the truth. And we better recognize that the differences between Republicans or Democrats are not small. They are massive. And this election is about that difference and ensuring we choose the right road. Because if we stay on the one we are on right now, our children are going to be badly hurt by that.
Well, when you're talking about national security, one of the exit poll questions was about, are you worried about a terror attack? When you look at the breakdown about who scored well on the Republican side, Donald Trump wound up with 35% of the people who responded to our exit pollers. Meanwhile, Kasich had 15, Cruz had 12, and Marco Rubio had just 11%. Why do you think Donald Trump wound up with a number three times yours?
Well, look, Donald, the number you just read me sounds just like the number he got on the ballot. So clearly when people support someone, they think they're good at everything, and that's why they support them. So I want too focused on that. I can tell you I know exactly how to stop terrorism, and it isn't just with a series of speeches with harsh words. You are not going to scare ISIS into closing shop simply by saying that you're going to destroy them. How are you going to do it? Don't the voters of South Carolina deserve to know how the next president of the United States is going to specifically confront a threat like ISIS? Well, that's what we're about to find out over the next 10 days. It's not enough to, you know, elect someone that talks mean. You got to know what the plan is. And we have a plan. We've been talking about it for a long time. It's a plan that works, and it's one that I think the people of South Carolina are going to rally behind.
Absolutely. All right, Marco Rubio, you are a fighter. We know you're heading down to the Palmetto State very shortly. Good luck to you, sir, and thanks for joining us today from Fox and Friends here in New Hampshire. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
All right, good luck to you.